Hi there, so welcome to phase F, and that's migration planning phase. Phase F addresses the detailed migration planning, that is how to move from a baseline to the target architecture. Some of the key activities that are performed in this phase are, for the work packages and the projects that are identified, perform a cost-benefit analysis and a risk assessment, and finalize a detailed implementation and a migration plan. Let's look at the objective. There are 3 points here. First, the objective of this phase is to finalize architecture roadmap and the supporting implementation and migration plan. Second objective is that ensure implementation and migration plan is coordinated with enterprise approach to managing and implementation changes. What it means is that if there is an enterprise-wide rule or practice, say for example, all the projects in the organization follow Scrum or Agile methodology, then you cannot go and implement your project as a waterfall approach. You need to align with organization practice. And the very important objective, ensure the business value and cost of work packages and transition architecture is understood by key stakeholders. I believe the objectives are quite straightforward. Now let's look at the approach. The focus of phase F is the creation of an implementation and migration plan in cooperation with the portfolio and project managers. As mentioned before, project managers start getting involved in this phase. In phase F, the roadmap and the implementation and migration plan, which was in complete state in phase E, are integrated with enterprise other change activity. And these other activities include accessing the dependencies, cost, and benefit of the various migration projects. So the first step is to confirm management framework interaction. The organization may have a certain framework like how they run projects. For example, the organization may be heavily supporting Agile and there is a rule or a framework followed in the organization that all projects should run on Agile or should follow Scrum methodology rather than a waterfall approach. So the first step is to conform to this organization or business framework. Second is to assign a business value to each work packages, that is, how if a work package implementation is going to save company, say an X amount of money. For example, implementing the particular work package could save organization, say $100,000. Then this becomes the business value of the work package. Next is to estimate resource requirements. This step is all about understanding the costing of the project, planning, resource allocation to implement the work packages. Next, based on the business value and resource requirement, you will be able to prioritize the work packages so that those that has high business value and less resource utilization in terms of cost and time will be prioritized to implement. So you can get some quick wins and start showing the value of your architecture work. Showing a regular value of architecture work at various stages to the stakeholder, especially to the business, is very important to the success of the architecture project. Next step is to confirm to the architecture roadmap and update the architecture definition document. Next step is to generate the migration and implementation plan. And next is to confirm the architecture development. So at the end of this step, architecture development is complete. You document the lessons learned and now we move to the implementation. That is to the next phase, implementation governance. So this covers the migration planning phase. I encourage you to read chapter 14 from the TOGAF document link as mentioned in the slide. Coming up next, phase G, implementation governance phase. Thank you, happy learning and God bless.